Welcome to Frankfurt Auto, and the tutorial is going to be on making threads with tap and die. So there are two different taps here. This one here is called a bottoming out tap. It's used for blind holes. And this one here is a taper tap. It's used for through holes or when you're starting off the thread. So we're going to be tapping at 3/8 national coarse. So you're going to need to find out which drill bit you need to use. Okay, so this is the tap drill chart that you need to look at. This column here, the first one, that's the tap you're going to be using. The second column tells you the bit number. And this is the closest one in the fraction if you don't have it in the bit number. In our case, we're going to be using 3/8 national coarse, which is this one here. And it says the drill bit that you need is 5/16. So after you center punch it, make sure you drill it with a 5/16 drill bit. Alright, so now we have our 5/16 hole drilled right there. Alright, so some things we're going to need here is going to be the tap holder itself, the tap, which is right there, and some cutting fluid, which is specific for cutting. Okay, so we're using the taper tap first here. In some cases where you're going into a blind hole, make sure that you put grease on these grooves here so that it picks up the metal and it doesn't fall into the hole. We're starting off with a taper tap here. Make sure you hold it 90 degrees to a piece of metal, so like this here. Now you're going to turn it clockwise and apply pressure at the same time. Add the cutting fluid, go half a turn forward, 3/4 turn back, or until you feel the chip break. Just add fluid as you need. If it's a through hole, just keep going until the tap is through. Our tap is through, now we're going to start taking it out. So here we're going to apply pressure up so that we don't end up ruining the thread here or cross-threading it. Alright, our thread is cut. We're just going to try 3/8 bolt, just to make sure it works well. And that's how you make a female thread.
Okay, so we're going to be making a 3/8 male thread. In order to do so, you need to use a 3/8 die, as you can see there. We're going to be using a 3/8 rod. And to make things easier for yourself, you want to taper the ends of the rod to make it easier to start the threads. Using a die, which is adjustable, like ours, you want to ensure that you start with the widest opening possible. If your die has one tapered end and one end which is not tapered, you want to ensure that the tapered end faces downwards so that you can begin your thread nicely. When it comes to placing your handle, you want to ensure that this groove right here, this groove, is facing upwards so that once placing your die in and you apply pressure, it doesn't slip upwards. Also, in our case, we're going to be positioning the die like this so that we can tighten the bolt down on that groove. Because if we place it like this, when it comes to tightening this bolt, it's going to close the gap. So you want to ensure that it's like this. Once you have your tools ready to go, apply the handle 90 degrees to the rod apply lube, cutting lube, apply lots of pressure downwards, and begin your cut. You want to give it half a turn forwards, half a turn backwards, so that you can break the chip. You can see the chip is forming there, and once we bring it back, we cut the chip off and continue. Once you're taking your die off, as soon as you are nearing the end of it, you want to ensure that you begin applying pressure upwards, like pushing it up like this, just so that you don't risk breaking your threads. Now that you've finished making your threads, as you can see here, and you try putting your bolt on, your nut, if it gets stuck, it means that we are going to have to repeat the dyeing process, except this time what we have to do, we have to grab a screwdriver and shorten the distance. Like so. Close off that gap.
In order to make the nut fit better on the threads here, we're going to need to go over it one more time with the die, but this time we're going to need to close it in further so that it makes the threads a little bit deeper here. When positioning the die, make sure that this groove lines up with the bolt right here. So it's going to go in like so. And then tighten your bolt down to close that gap. Make sure to use your cutting lube.
And now that we have gone all the way down and back up, our nut should fit nice and snug. There's no play. Very little play, and it goes up and down smoothly.